Hello everyone, warm greetings from Rainbow School. By now I'm sure most of you must have seen our pep talk show by our children. So what exactly is this pep talk? Pep talk is basically a platform for our children to express their thoughts in a meaningful way. So there are also children from primary section who have come forward to talk about various topics. Maybe in the first two, three talk shows they're not doing much, but I'm sure every step is a learning, and one day they will be a very confident speaker, all right? And this is going to improve their personality and public speaking skills. So we all seek your blessings and appreciation. Please encourage them. Thank you.
You and I are very special and unique if we recognize our strength. Today, I stand to talk about an ordinary man who has reached the pinnacle of glory by the dint of hard work. Perseverance and determination, she had become the source of inspiration to every woman in the world. Over her entire career, she has been known for making simple the complex. Whatever the issue you gave it to her, it will get addressed. Such is her unprecedented optimism. She is the CEO of PepsiCo and one of the most powerful women in the world. She is Indra Nooyi, who does not need any introduction. She was not born with a silver spoon in her mouth. We always tend to look at the success stories of people and often forgot, or rather do not like to dwell on their difficulties and failures on their way of success. In fact, Indra came from the humble origins. She was born and brought up in Madras. Despite difficulties and tribulations, she was encouraged and inspired by her mother. Her mother rooted the leadership qualities by asking Indra and her sister to write speeches to topics like, "What would you do if you're prime minister or chief minister?" She attributes all her successes to her mother and her grandfather. Her grandfather, who was a chief, who would say always, "If you're given a job, do it well, or no, don't do it at all." The rigor drew her into the prestigious IIM Calcutta. When she was 25 years old, she joined Yale University and worked as night shift receptionist at a hotel nearby to fund her studies. When she was 39, she joined PepsiCo Chief Financial Officer. Like many women, she also struggled to manage both family and work. Despite great challenges, she made herself to learn indispensable at the workplace. At the age of 51, she became president and chief executive of PepsiCo. Her message to all of us is, please remain a lifelong student and don't lose the curiosity. She says, greatness comes not from the position, but from helping building the future. Thank you.